This section is all about understanding the layers panel, and it will soon become apparent to you as you start designing with vector objects that you accumulate a lot of layers. So let's see how it works. So I'm going to design a really simple party person. So I'm going to start off with a rounded rectangle. I'm going to click and drag that out like this. There we go. Just drag that down a little bit more. And I need a head, so I'm going to click on the ellipse tool. I'm going to click here, hold down Command and Shift, so it starts drawing it out from the center. Okay, there's the head. And now we need a party hat, of course. So I'm going to click on this and go to Triangle tool. I'm going to draw a little triangle hat there. Okay, now I'm going to switch to the Move tool. So I'm going to go ahead and click on that. Shortcut is V. I'm going to click on the party hat and just place it slightly sideways like that. In fact, I think I'll make everything smaller. So how do I do that? I'll just click and drag over all of the objects, and they're all selected now, as you can see in the layers panel, and I can just size it down. So I can drag from the corner, and oh look, I don't want it to squash, so I just hold down Shift and I can drag it like that. I can also hold down Command and just drag down from the center. So somewhere like that looks good. I'm just zooming a little bit. Okay, so I can drag that hat up a little bit. We need some color now to make sense of all of this. So the party hat, I don't want any stroke on that, so I'll get rid of that. I'll go to the color, make it purple. Great. For the guy, I'll just choose some kind of orangey color. There we go. I've got the color for the head, and I'll just choose, I don't know, blue again for the body. So very simple, but this is all about the layers panel, okay? So if we go over to the layers panel here, we can see that the hat is on the top. And basically, any layer that is on the top will be seen first. And you can see it's lying over the head, which is slightly behind, and that is behind the hat there. So that's the second in line. And then third in line is the body. You see, you can't see through to it. But let's say with the body, I could move it above the head, and now it will be covering the head. So I'll just press Command Z to go back for a second. When you're working with lots of layers, it's really important to know what they all are, because some can look very similar. So I suggest you go through each one and name them. So we've got triangle here, it says. I want to call this hat. So I'm just going to double tap here. I'm going to type in hat. And this one I'll put head. And I'll double tap on the last one and call that body. So now I know what they all are at a glance. So like I was showing you, you can click on these layers here. So you can click and drag them up. And you can see as you drag them up, you can see this little blue line. You could just let go and you can see what it's like, or you could drag it all the way to the top. You wouldn't see a difference there anyway. You can do it like that, or you can also use the quick actions. So remember at the top here, we have arrange. So if I click on this one, I just press forward one. Click on that and it's gone forward one in the layers panel. If I go back here, I wonder if I could send it back. Yes, I can. Back one. I click that. So these can be very useful for you. Like the last one here, move to front if it's all the way at the back. So you can use these quick options to arrange your layer stack. And when you get really used to using layers, you can use shortcuts. So with the body selected, I can simply press Command and right bracket key. See in the bottom left-hand corner, you can see Command and left bracket key to send it back. I'll do it a few times so you can see Command right bracket key forward, Command left bracket key to send it back. So you can press that as many times as you want to go up to the top and back. So this can be really useful when you've just selected it from here and you don't want to go all the way to the layers panel. You could just start playing with that shortcut. And also, let's say I wanted to move this whole thing over to the left hand side. Yes, I can go ahead and select it all like that and move it across. But if I'm going to be moving a lot of things around and there's lots of other shapes around that I don't want to select, I can always do this. I can select them all from here, or I can go into the layers panel. See here, I select the first one, and if I hold down Shift on the keyboard and click the last one, it will select all of them, and then I could move them around. If I just wanted to select, let's say, the hat and then the body, I select the hat first, that's highlighted. I press Command and I click on the body. Now just those two are selected and I can just move them around. But when the layers start getting out of control, you'll start thinking about how to group them. So if I wanted to group all of these together, I could simply select the first one, hold Shift, select the last one, and then I could just right click. And you see, we've got a few options here. I could just press Group. But remember, there's a shortcut, so you could press Command G. But I'll just press this for now. And you can see now that this is in a group. It's called Group. You could name that Party Person if you wanted. In fact, I will. So party person, and then we've got a little arrow here. So I can click on that arrow and see what's within the group. And obviously this group, I can just go ahead and select it and move it around anywhere I want. And remember, we can duplicate it as well. So I could just hold down command, click and drag. And now it's a real party now. Okay, let me press command Z to go back a few steps. So also you might want to ungroup it if you don't want that grouped anymore. How do you do that? Well, you just right click on it again and press ungroup. So let's use the shortcut, shall we? I'll select all of them and I'm just going to press Command and G. You see it's in a group already. I no longer want it in a group. Okay, Shift Command G. Now they're not in a group anymore. That simple. Also, sometimes you might want to lock a layer because you don't want it to move. Maybe you're playing around with another portion of the design. You can do that. So right now, I'll select the body. And over on the layers panel, see if I just hover over to this section here, I can press lock. And now that way, let's say if I just want to select those two, even if I select all of this, it'll only select the hat and the head, not the body, because that's locked. I can't even move it. So the way to unlock it would be just to click on the padlock icon again, toggle lock, and now I can move it around again. Also, sometimes you might want to hide a layer. And basically, this is very easy as well. You select the head, go over here, and it says toggle visibility. I can click on that, and now it's hidden. It's still there, so if you ever want it back, you could just look here, go through your layers panel, and you can see the white circles means it's visible, and the darker one there means it's not. So you just click that again, and now it's visible. You'll also notice in the layers panel, there's something called opacity there. So if I just select the head and go over to opacity, I can drag that down, and it's much like the fill opacity right up here. So there's just plenty of ways to play around with opacity, okay? And the other thing is, you see here it says normal. These are all blend modes as I cycle through. You can't really see what's going on right now. So what I'm gonna do is I'm just gonna move these two out of the way. I'm gonna duplicate this. Remember how we did it before? I just hold command, click, and drag out a little bit. And I want to make a couple of duplicates and change the color so they're all slightly different. And then I'm going to play with the blend modes. So with the green one selected, I'm going to go over to normal. Those are blend modes. And you see darken, you can start seeing through. It reacts differently to, I guess, the different colors, how light or dark each color is underneath. And you see, you can play around with these and get a style that you want. Okay, moving on.